So today we will start the syllabus of our service oriented architecture subject. Today we will cover the introduction or definition part, evolution of service oriented architecture, then definition of service oriented architecture. So let us start. Before starting the definition of service oriented architecture, let us see the how this service oriented architecture evolutionary path looks like. Evolutionary path means evolution of service oriented architecture. We know that there are different architectural style. Software engineering is one of the architectural style. Then object oriented analysis and designing is one of the architectural style. And now we are studying the new architectural style, that is the service oriented architecture. So how this architectural style evolved? Today we are moving from single tier architecture to multi-tier architecture. So single tier architecture means what? In initial days, organization used the mainframe computers, and all the data, all the systems are present on mainframe computers, and all these systems accessed by the client with the help of user ID and password. So valid client gives the request to the server identifies the user, and if the authorized user is there, then only this mainframe computer gives the access to the client, and then client use the application, computerized application. All the three layers, that layer may be presentation layer, business logic layer, or database layer. All the three layers are present on one computer. So number of lines code is again increased. In the olden days, while using software engineering and single tier architecture, so modifying this code is very difficult. No separation among the presentation, business logic, database layer, and due to that, hard to maintain. And one more drawbacks of this single tier architecture is no reusability, difficult to update. So difficult to update the code. In 2000 line, it is very difficult to understand the line by line execution and change one single line and once again see the execution. So it is difficult. And in monolithic application, whenever we are making any changes in the system, we have to recompile, relink, redeploy every time there is a change. So today is the need of moving from single tier architecture to multi tier architectures. After single tier architecture, we have seen one more methodology, that is object oriented analysis and designing architectural style, and that represent that moving from monolithic model to object based application model. In object based application model, we know that there are many advantages of this object based application model over the single tier architecture or monolithic model. The advantages are the reusability. We can reuse the components or code. Then this object based application models are easier to update. Whenever I want to update anything, I am able to update in quickly, because we have again separated the code. In we have written the presentation logic separate, business logic separate, database logic separate, and due to that we can able to suppose I have changed the presentation layer, no need to change the business logic and database. Suppose I have changed the business logic, no need to change presentation and database. So like that. So object based is what? Reusable, easier to update, and no need to down the system, compile the part of the software at runtime. So in object oriented analysis and designing, what we have seen that? So people are organization moving from single tier architecture to object based application, or multi-tier architecture. So the next evolutionary path is moving from application based client, so application based client, to HTML browser based client. So what are the advantages of this HTML browser based client? So HTML browser based client can use the application with the help of browser. So prerequisite is internet is there, so internet is required, and due to that internet we can access that application from anywhere with the help of browser. So no need to work from one place, so you can access the system from anywhere with the help of any device which is internet enabled. With the help of browser we can access these systems. So this is what the evolutionary path. Some disadvantages of monolithic model can be resolved by object based model, and now this object based model we are moving towards the HTML browser based model. Object oriented analysis and designing, generally we use the three tier architecture, and that three tier architectures are having still some flaws, I can say. So why that again all together as a new architectural style is required? So because of it does not. So object oriented analysis and designing three tier architecture does not address the needs of tomorrow's enterprise. So tomorrow's enterprise is ready to serve his customer as per his demand, as per his feedback. So they are ready to make the changes in the existing document. So organizations are again flexible, so that the system, they required the flexible systems if they want some changes. So daily they are able to make the changes in their web application, so that their customer is again satisfied and fulfilled. Then time to market. So whenever they want to make any changes, that changes while making the changes, the organizations are again ready to serve the market quickly. So changes are again made in the existing system quickly. Then point to point integration of different systems. So point to point integration means take the example of Boeing is one of the company who manufacture the Airbus, and they using more than 1700 applications in their single organization. So this 1700 applications, so point to point integration, so integration of this 1700 application is difficult, because in the olden days the older technologies are again included for development, and now in modern days the modern technologies are again used for development. Then the question is arise that how these modern technologies are again interacting with the older technologies, or that legacy applications. So how to interact with the legacy applications or ERP applications, existing applications with the modern applications. So for that we required altogether different technologies, and using that different technology or architectural style can solve this problem, point to point integration problem. So similarly, the many organizations are having multiple systems, developing multiple technologies, and they want to share the information amongst the applications. Again, organization want cost effective solutions, faster development. Operation and maintenance is again one of the bigger issues today, so they want to resolve that. And the last thing is leveraging the internet effectively. How to use the internet effectively? So if the organization use the internet effectively, so the employee can work 24/7, 365 a day. So day and night employee can able to work on the organizational project. They have the access to the data. So work from home is also possible whenever we are using internet effectively. B2C is solved. So B2C problem, how the organization solved the B2C problem? So they develop high-end applications, websites, and through that web application websites, they develop the website and customer visit the website, and customer, in case of e-commerce site, customer purchase the product from that e-commerce site. So for that they develop the simple and effective sites. So B2C is solved, but B2B is the issue now. B2B means business to business. Now we are again shifting from e-commerce to collaborative commerce. Collaborative commerce means multiple organization want to work in a collaboration. So working in a collaboration is possible only when they interact or they share the data amongst them, and sharing the data amongst them is possible only when they use this new architectural style, service oriented architecture. Because we know that in object oriented analysis and designing, ASP.NET code is again used in reusable in ASP.NET only, or Java code is reusable in Java technology only. So therefore in B2B environment, the organization may have different technologies, but still they want to do the business, still they want to share the data amongst them. So Amazon, take the example of Amazon, and Amazon is doing the business with thousands and lakhs of organizations online with the help of service oriented architecture. Amazon is one of the good example of they have implemented service oriented architecture very nicely. So now the shift is, so organizations are again shifting from component or object based model to service oriented architectural model. So let us in service oriented architecture, what is meaning by service orientation or service oriented mean? So service oriented is what? The logic is required to solve a large problem. So how the large problems are again solved with the help of service oriented architecture? So in service oriented architecture, the large programs are divided into smaller and related pieces. So decomposition method is used, and with the help of decomposition method, the large problems are divided into smaller pieces, and each piece of this each pieces address a concern or a specific part of the problem. So that each piece in service oriented architectural language, it is called as a service. You develop a small service or microservice, so that identify the problem and divide that problem into small pieces, and that piece represent simply a service, and develop such services so that organization can solve their problems. Take the example that if the banking organization is there, they do the banking business in their legal timing 10 to 5 or 9 to 5, but suppose I want some banking services on my handheld device 24/7, then they came up with the service oriented architectural model, that with the help of that model they are providing few services to the end users, and these services are, now suppose I want to transfer the amount, that transferring amount with the help of mobile application is possible. Then balance inquiry. So they provide many small services to the end users, and nowadays end user is rarely visit the organizations and do their work on their own. So let us see the definition of service oriented architecture. We have seen that service orientation means what? decomposition. The large problem is again divided into small pieces, and that piece is again developed. So organizations or developer are working on that small piece of the work. And here in service oriented architecture, the architectural job is to look at overall construction of IT system or resources to ensure interoperability. So interoperability means beyond the technologies. So Java technology interact with ASP.NET, ASP.NET technology interact with PHP, PHP technology interact with Python. So one more job of architect is service identification and align them in a service oriented architecture to build a flexible solution. So nowadays service oriented architecture can be a big investment. So let us see the definition of service oriented architecture. So service oriented architecture is what? Is a term that represent a model, just like software engineering or object oriented analysis and designing. So service oriented architecture is also a model, and these models are based on decomposition method. So automation logic is again decomposed into smaller and distinct unit of logic, small piece of logic, and collectively these units comprises, when we connect multiple services, combines multiple services, it serves the purpose of business logic, business automation logic. And individually these units, these small units can be distributed. I can distribute one small service, I can distribute this small service in pieces or in a group. So that is the beauty of the service oriented architecture. So in service oriented architecture, it is an architectural model based on decomposition process, and while decomposition, we are dividing that big problem into smaller piece, smaller distinct unit of logic, and that smaller distinct unit of logic is called as services. So these unit of logics are known as services, and with the help of these services we are developing the applications. So as I have given you the example of Amazon, so Amazon use different web services, and through the web services they are sharing the data amongst their business partners. Again the bank uses this service oriented architecture, and with the help of this service oriented architecture, bank provide you multiple services on the handheld devices. Again nowadays paying online paying online the bill is possible with the help of this service oriented architecture. Service oriented architecture nowadays used in many applications. So tours and travel system, they use the service oriented architecture for booking purpose. Then airline booking, they use service oriented architecture. Again in railway, they use service oriented architecture. So day by day the many organizations, they are adopting this service oriented architecture. So today we have covered a few topics. The first one is the evolutionary path. So moving from single tier architecture to multi tier architecture, then monolithic to object based, then application based client to browser based client. Again, why service oriented architecture is required? Because changing needs of the user, time to market, point to point integration, cost effective, then fast development, operation and maintenance is also one of the issues, and now use of internet effectively. So component and object based application server to service oriented architecture. Then in service orientation, the meaning of service oriented we have covered, that the large problem is decomposed into small related pieces, and each of these pieces address a concern. So in banking application, withdrawal is one concern, then deposit is one concern, then balance inquiry is one concern, transferring amount from one account to another account is a concern. So these are the small pieces addressed by the service oriented microservice, we can say. And the definition of service oriented architecture is similarly that the logic, automation logic, is decomposed into smaller distinct unit of logic, and these unit of logics are individually distributed to the user as per his need, as per his role. And these units of logics are known as services. So in the next lecture we'll cover, I am going to cover web service framework. Again, in web service framework, how this if the organization thought of using service oriented architecture, so how they developed these services, and how these services are again published, then how customer or client can access these services, and how these interoperable systems are again developed. So that I am going to cover in the next lecture. So today I am covering this much only. Thank you.